Hello, it's Missy. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a high bun type hairstyle. Be sure to subscribe if you're new, click that notification bell, then you'll never miss any future videos. And let's get started. For this hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing out any hair that I'd like to leave out to frame my face. Then I'm going to brush all of the hair up into a high ponytail, and then use a hairband to tie off the hair, creating a ponytail. The ponytail is going to end up being divided into four equal sections to create the bun. So I'm going to divide off the first section of hair near the top. I'm taking a clear elastic band and I'm going to tie this partway down the section about 3 or so inches from the top. Then I'm going to create a gap above the elastic band and flip the ends through the gap so the two sides become twisted. Then I'm going to gently pull on small pieces of hair around this twisted section so it becomes puffier and more full. Once it's nice and big, I'm going to bring the elastic band up above the hairband and place it against my head. Then I'm going to use some bobby pins and slide these into the hair to pin it in place. This first section is going to create the top left portion of the bun. I'm going to make sure to pin a section of hair from the twisted piece into the hair against the head to secure it in place. Now I'm going to divide off a new section of hair from the ponytail. This will be the top right portion of the bun. So I'm going to tie the elastic band over the section of hair a few inches down. Then I'm going to create a gap in the hair right above the elastic band and flip the ends through the gap to twist both side sections. Then I can go back over the hair and gently pull on small pieces to make the twisted sections bigger and puffier. Then I'm going to roll the elastic band up towards the top of the ponytail so the twisted section creates a roll and the elastic band is against my head. Then I'm going to slide bobby pins into the hair to pin it in place against my head. You don't really need to open the bobby pins. I'm simply hooking a bit of hair from the rolled section and then sliding the pin into the hair against the head, and this will hold it in place. Now I'm going to divide the remaining hair from the ponytail into two equal sections. I'm going to start with the right side, and this will become the bottom right portion of the bun. Using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie this over the section of hair, and I'm going to create a gap in the hair right above the elastic band. Then I'm going to flip the ends through the gap to twist both side sections. Then I'm going to go back over the hair and carefully pull on small pieces to make the twisted side sections bigger and puffier. Then I'm going to tuck the section under itself. Then I'm going to pin it in place by sliding bobby pins through small pieces of the ponytail hair and then into the hair from my head. Now I'm going to combine the ends that are left hanging down from the ponytail and combine them together to create the last section of the bun. I'm taking another clear elastic band and tying this over the hair a few inches down from the top. Once it's tied off, I'm going to create a gap in the hair above the elastic band, flip the ends through the gap to create the two twisted side sections. And then I'm going to tuck the elastic underneath so it's against the head next to the ponytail hairband. If there's any additional hair sticking out from the bun, I'm just going to repeat the same steps and tie another elastic band over the section to combine the hair together. I'm flipping the ends through a gap above the elastic band to create another topsy-tail section, and then I'm going to tuck it underneath the base of the bun and pin it in place with bobby pins. Once everything is pinned up, I'm going to go back over the style and just detail it a little bit. I'm pulling on small sections to ensure the bun is symmetrical all the way around, and then use a medium hold hairspray to smooth down any loose hairs or flyaways. For this hairstyle, I'm going to begin by prepping my hair. I'm going to divide out some hair to frame my face and smooth these down with a flat iron. Then I'm going to divide out sections of hair at my crown and gently back comb the sections to create some volume at the top of the hairstyle. Now I'm going to separate out a center section of hair on my head to use for the beginning of the bun. I'm going to create a circular part line going around my entire head, leaving out a section of hair around my entire hairline. I'm going to use a hairband and tie it off into a high ponytail. Now I'm going to divide off a 1-inch section of hair at the top of the ponytail. I'm going to twist this section together and lay the twist in front of the hairband so it's going from left to right, and then I'm going to use a couple bobby pins to pin the twist in place. Now I'm going to divide off another 1-inch section of hair underneath the first and twist the hair all together. I'm going to lay this twist the opposite direction, slightly behind the first one, and I'm going to pin it in place against my head using a couple more bobby pins. Now I'm going to take another section and wrapping it underneath the previous section going towards the right side. I'm using a few bobby pins to pin both the left and the right sides of the twist. Once that's done, I'm going to start taking the ends from the previous twists and begin pinning them around the bun. I am using these sections to kind of fill in any gaps in the bun, create some more symmetry, and add some height to the bun as well. I'm taking each section, twisting the hair together into a tight twist, and then laying them either over the bun or around the outside edges. Once all of the ends are pinned around the bun, I'm going to start detailing the hair that was left down around the hairline. Starting at the top of my head, I'm going to take small sections from around my face and twist and pin these at the edge of the bun. I divided the hair at the very top of my head into three smaller sections, and I just twisted and pinned each section right at the edge of the bun. Then I pinned the two side sections above both of my ears. So I'm just smoothing these down with a comb and hairspraying them to keep them smooth. And I'm sliding the bobby pins into the hair so that they're going in towards the bun. I'm also going to take the hair at the nape of my neck and pin these as well. I'm taking the entire section and dividing it into three smaller pieces. Taking each section individually, I'm going to twist these up towards the bun as well and pin them in place along the edge. I'm also going to take any ends that are hanging down and follow the same pattern, twisting and pinning these around the outside of the bun to help create a larger, fuller looking bun. This style takes a little more creativity since it's kind of built piece by piece, but this way you're able to style the bun however you prefer. For the next hairstyle, the first thing I'm going to do is brush the hair straight back from my forehead. Then I'm creating a center part line down the middle of the head to split the hair into two equal sections. Then I'm going to divide out a section of hair for the first braid. This will be on the right side of the part and only needs to be about an inch or so big. I'm dividing the section into three smaller pieces to create a braid. I'm crossing the side strands over the center strand, alternating between the right and left side strands to begin the braid. And I'm just going to continue this pattern, working my way down the section of hair. So I'm just crossing the two side strands, alternatively over the middle strand, until the braid reaches down near the ends of the section. When the braid reaches the end, I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom, and I'll be tying the two braids together eventually. So now I'm going to repeat the same steps as before. I'm dividing out a 1-inch section of hair on the left side of the middle part. I'm splitting this section into three smaller pieces and creating a second braid at the top of my head. I'm crossing the left and right side strands over the center strand, working down towards the ends of the hair. These braids can also be done braiding the hair forwards and then flipped back on themselves. I chose not to do them this way just so they would lay a little flatter at the top of my head. Once the braid reaches the ends, I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to take the remaining hair and brush it all up towards the crown of my head. Using a hairband to combine the hair together, I'm going to wrap it into a high ponytail. Now I'm going to take the two braids and cross one over the other. Then I'm going to wrap the ends of the braids around the hairband towards the back side of the ponytail. Using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the two braids together underneath. Now I'm going to take the hairband and wrap it once more over the ponytail. If it's too tight, you can simply use another hairband, but I'm going to wrap the hairband partway over the ponytail. The hairband should create a small loop or bun in the hair behind the forward hanging pieces of hair. Now with the ends hanging out the front of the bun, I'm going to take a tiny curling iron and curl small sections of hair, alternating between curling the hair towards the face and away from my face so it lays in different curl patterns. I am using a half inch curling wand from Bedhead, and I'll link it down in the description box. Once all of my hair is curled, I'm going to shape the hairstyle by pinning down any sections that are sticking out. I'm just sliding bobby pins into the back loop part of the bun so that it's flush with the head and there aren't any gaps between the hair and my head. If any of the curls are longer, I'm going to pin them up so they lay over the head instead of hanging off the sides. Then I'm going to smooth down the sides of my hair using a medium or stronghold hairspray. I love this style. I think it's so different and fun. Let me know what you think down in the comments. That wraps up today's tutorial. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. Be sure to like and subscribe if you're new. Click that notification bell as always, then you'll never miss future videos. And I will see you next time.